I'm Jason Horsch, owner of Xanadu Gallery in Scottsdale and Pine Top, Arizona, and this is a moment in art history where we look at great works of art, share their stories, talk about their impact, and I give you my reaction to the work. Today's artwork is Adam by Auguste Rodin. This familiar sculpture of a contorted, tortured Adam first appeared as a standalone piece at the Paris Salon in 1881 under the title The Creation of Man. Later that year, France's Ministry of Fine Arts commissioned large Adam and Eve figures as part of Rodin's Gates of Hell project. He reused The Creation of Man for the figure of Adam and started to work on the Eve sculpture to pair with it. Rodin's Gates of Hell were inspired by the menacing gates that appear at the beginning of Dante's Inferno, along with the message, "Abandon all hope, ye who enter here." This warning may have echoed often in Rodin's head as he imagined the colossal gates and terrifying figures that would stand at the entrance of Paris's new Decorative Arts Museum. In an article in a French newspaper, Rodin said, "For a whole year, I lived with Dante, with him alone, drawing the eight circles of his inferno. At the end of this year, I realized that while my drawings rendered my vision of Dante, they had become too remote from reality. So I started all over again, working from nature with my models." Rodin had been sketching figures from the dismal first book of the Divine Comedy even before the commission started bringing them to life in 3D forms. Rodin's rendering of Adam for the gates particularly illustrates the hopelessness present at the entrance of Dante's version of hell. His eyes are downcast in shame at humanity's first sin, and his finger points down to the earth, contrasting the well-known image of Adam reaching toward God on the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel. Unfortunately, the museum was never built, and Rodin never completed his Gates of Hell, but he continued to work on the project until his death in 1917. In an interesting twist on the biblical story, Rodin's Adam never saw the completion of the dark creation where he was supposed to stand. Though Rodin's Gates of Hell was never completed, some of Rodin's most famous pieces, including The Thinker and The Kiss, also arose as parts of the sculptor's vision for this piece. There's something hopeful in the beautiful parts Rodin created as part of an unfinished whole. Despite all of his visions of hell, Rodin created a profound statement about the beauty that can arise from human imperfection. While I would place Rodin alongside Michelangelo, Donatello, and Bernini as one of the greatest sculptors who has ever lived, Rodin's work was highly criticized as he forged a new language in sculpture and eventually came to be considered the father of modern sculpture. Born in 1840 to a working-class family, Rodin taught himself to draw before studying at the Petite École, a school specializing in mathematics, but where he studied painting and drawing. He failed to gain admission to the École des Beaux-Arts after three attempts, and so set out to build a career as a craftsman and ornamenter for the next two decades. Eventually, Rodin had the opportunity to work with the animal sculptor, Antoine-Louis Barré. Barré's attention to detail and his finely detailed musculature of animals in motion was a significant influence on Rodin. Through various positions in the Decorative Arts in Paris studios and a porcelain factory, Rodin began to earn recognition for his work. Eventually, his sculpture began to find its way into the Paris salons, where it garnered mixed reviews. Many of Rodin's most notable sculptures were criticized as they clashed with the predominant figurative sculpture tradition, in which works were decorative, formulaic, or highly thematic. Rodin's most original work departed from traditional themes of mythology and allegory. He modeled the human body with naturalism, and his sculptures celebrated individual character and physicality. I've long loved Rodin's sculptures. In 1995, when I was 20, I had the opportunity to see a major exhibit of Rodin sculptures and photography in Brazil at the Pinacoteca de São Paulo. This exhibit, a collaboration between the Pinacoteca and the Museu Rodin in Paris, was a major event in Brazil. Over 183,000 people attended the show over the course of the exhibit. I might have been too young and naive at the time to fully appreciate the sculptural work I saw on display, and I was unfamiliar with Rodin and his sculpture, but I knew I was experiencing something incredible. Rodin's sculpture pulsed with life. He had transformed cold bronze into flesh and blood. Several years after returning to the U.S., I read Frederick Grunfeld's epic biography of the artist. Now, I've read many artist biographies over the years, but few have had such a powerful impact. This book is, I believe, now out of print, but if you can pick up a used copy, it's well worth the read. I've only been able to scratch the surface of this amazing artist's life today. Thanks for joining me for a moment in art history. If you enjoyed this bit of art history, be sure to subscribe so that you'll be notified about future art history videos. I'd love to hear your impression of Rodin's Adam. Do you like the sculpture? Have you seen any of the castings in person? What is your favorite Rodin piece? Leave your thoughts in the comments below. I look forward to seeing you in the next moment in art history.